The Washington State Department of Transportation, or WSDOT, is undergoing a large effort to correct barriers to fish created by culverts along the highway system. While culverts are used to safely carry water underneath highways, some are too high for fish to reach, others don't carry streams deep enough to allow fish to swim through, and others allow water to flow too fast for fish to swim against. Each barrier correction project is unique and varies in the amount of time needed for completion. Engineers and biologists begin by evaluating the existing conditions, including the width, the change in elevation of the stream channel, the depth of ground from roadway to culvert, as well as other elements like nearby roads and driveways. WSDOT meets with the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife, as well as tribes, to determine specific site parameters, which helps create the preliminary design. WSDOT must follow the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife's water crossing design guidelines when designing a fish-passable structure. These guidelines direct WSDOT to correct the barrier with a bridge, or what is called a stream simulation culvert. Stream simulation is intended for the stream crossing to mimic natural stream processes, so fish can't tell they are swimming under the roadways. While stream widths may be similar on several projects, other stream elements are rarely exactly the same. Each unique project design also takes site characteristics into consideration and accounts for risks associated with a stream naturally changing course over time. Due to the dynamic nature of streams, properly evaluating upstream and downstream conditions is crucial so the structure is sized and located properly, and the design matches the existing stream. Because the structure size and stream design are such important design elements, they must be agreed to by key project partners and stakeholders. After the preliminary design work is complete and the structure size is determined, engineers work to design the structure. When possible, standard designs are used to reduce design and construction time. In addition, WSDOT geotechnical engineers gather information on soil conditions for the design of the structure's foundation. Conditions under the ground can vary considerably at each barrier location, and WSDOT needs to design the structures to be stable, resilient to earthquakes, and operational for many decades. In addition, fill depths vary and affect structure type and need for retaining walls. The design phase includes documenting environmental impacts and obtaining permits for construction activities, which varies from project to project. In general, fish passage projects are complex, with many different existing natural resources, like wetlands, trees, and cultural resources in and around the project site. While these projects improve fish habitat, there are often short and long-term environmental effects that need to be understood and addressed. WSDOT looks for ways to improve process efficiencies related to documentation and permitting. Since WSDOT must ensure that the new stream channel ties into the existing stream, WSDOT frequently needs to work with adjacent property owners to obtain the necessary rights and access permissions to build the stream channel. WSDOT works to avoid affecting adjacent features like driveways, access points, and buildings to correct fish barriers. Utilities that convey internet, electricity, and other vital services commonly run along state highways. Since WSDOT must often dig large holes in the road to replace culverts, these utilities need to be relocated, either temporarily or permanently, before construction occurs. This is a major consideration and requires coordination and planning with many utility companies to ensure vital services to adjacent communities are not disrupted. After all of the project elements have been decided, engineers put the final designs together and assemble construction contracts, specifications, and estimates. In some cases, bundling fish barrier correction projects into a single construction contract is more efficient for both design and construction, and ultimately lessens the overall traffic impacts. Tying into adjacent driveways, designing safety elements like guardrail, and managing traffic during construction are additional considerations. There are also considerations for the timing of construction events. For example, projects require work in the stream bed, and this can only occur during specific times, often in the summer months. Weather is also a consideration, as heavy rainfalls could delay project activities. WSDOT must also consider timing restrictions around local events. Each of these considerations will be different at each site. Once the project elements have been designed and the contracts are complete, the project is advertised to contractors who place bids on performing the work. The selected contractor then begins building the project according to their contract and work windows. Designing each of these unique fish passage projects requires time and coordination to ensure that culverts not only carry water safely underneath roadways, but maintain access to streams and rivers for fish. While no project is exactly the same, and the differences of each project are crucial to consider, WASHDOT constantly looks for opportunities to make complex processes related to design efforts more efficient. For more information, visit WASHDOT's Fish Passage webpages. Thank you for listening.